Hello everyone, I am Chalma Reddy. Welcome to CR Maths class. In previous class, we are completed level 1, 25 problems. Now, I am going to solve the 26th question. Students, see the 26th question. How to solve these questions? Verification method. By verification method. So tell me here how to take. Now I am going to take that n is equal to 2 onwards. If you are taken n is equal to 1, more than one option can be satisfied. Okay. So if n is equal to 2, we are taken means we get answer easily. So substitute in the question 2c0 whole square. Plus 3 into 2c1 whole square plus 5 into 2c2 whole square. Students, calculate this. 2c0 means 1. 1 square value is 1. Plus here 2c1, 2. 2 square, 4. 4 threes are 12. Plus here 2c2 means 1, 1 square is 1, 1 into 5, 5. Totally observe that 18 we got. If n is equal to 2, we are substituted in the question, we got answer 18. Now verify the options. I am going to verify the first option. 2 plus 1 into 2 square. 2 square means 4, 4 threes are 12. So this is wrong answer clearly. Now second option C. 2 2's are 4. 4 plus 1. Plus 2n c n is there. 2n means there is 4. 4c2. 4 plus 1 means 5. What is 4c2? 4 into 3 by 1 into 2. See, 2 2's are 4. 3 2's are 6. 6 5's are 30. So this is also wrong answer. Now verify the third option. 2 plus 1 into 2ncn mean that is 4c2. 2 plus 1 means 3. 4c2 means already we are calculated that is 6. 6 threes are 18. So this is the correct answer. Now verify the fourth option also. What we get? 2n minus 1, 2ncn. 2n means that is 4. 4 minus 1, 4c2. 4 minus 1 means 3. 4c2 means 6. This is 18. If you are taken n is equal to 2, these two options are coincide. Then what we have to do? Go to n is equal to 1. Substitute in the question. If n is equal to 1, what happened? C 1c0 whole square plus 3 into 1c1 whole square plus 5 into 1c2 cannot be exist. So calculate this. 1 plus 3 that is equal to 4. Now verify that if n is equal to 1, what happened? Third and fourth option. Now substitute n is equal to 1 in third option. 1 plus 1, 2c1. That means this is 4. Yes. Here also match. Fourth option, see that? If you are substituted 1, you get 2 minus 1 into 2c1. This is overall 2 only. So this is failed. Students, finally, if n is equal to 1 and n is equal to 2, only third option is satisfied. Remaining three options are failed. So correct answer is third option. Same method. Now, I am going to take n is equal to 1. n is equal to 1. Substitute in the question first. 1c0 1 by 1 into 2 plus 1c1 1 by 2 into 3. So here observe that LCM is 6, numerator we get 3 plus 1, 4 by 6, that is 2 by 3. Okay, now verify the first option. If n is equal to 1, what happened? So I'm writing directly 2 power 1 plus 1, this is 4 minus 1 divided by denominator 1 plus 1, 2, 1 plus 2, 3. 3 2s are 6. 4 minus 1, 3. 3 by 6, that is 1 by 2. So it is failed. Second option, 2 power n plus 2. 2 power n plus 2. That means 2 cube, 8. Minus 1, minus 3, divided by denominator. N plus 1 into n plus 2, that is 6. Now this is 4 by 6. 2 by 3, yes, it is satisfied. If it is satisfied means don't mark the answer. This is verification method. Verify four options, then mark the answer. Denominator will come to, this is 1 by 2. This is the wrong answer. Fourth option, see that? So first and fourth option, similar only, you'll get 4 plus 1. Just a small difference, plus minus like this. So fourth option, we are getting 5 by 6. This is also wrong. So finally, first option correct by verification method. So here, second option is correct, not first option. By mistake, I marked here. Second option, no. Second option is satisfied. Okay, next is the 28th question. Students, solve this question. How to do that? Same method. Take n is equal to 2. If n is equal to 1, you are taken means I think 2 option coincide. That's why 2c1 plus 2 into 2c2 into A. 2C2 into A. Now calculate this. 2 plus 2A. If n is equal to 2, we are taken, I am substituted in the question. I got 2 plus 2A. Now verify the options. If n is equal to 2 means first option is correct. See, 2 into 1 plus A. Whole power 2 minus 1. That is 1 only now. So first option is correct. Now verify the second option. 2 into 1 plus A whole square. So this is wrong clearly. Third option. 4 into 1 plus A whole cube. This is wrong. Fourth option. 4 into 1 plus A whole power 4. This is also wrong answer. So finally, which option is correct, students? First option. Now observe the question. X minus 2 whole power 100. That is equal to expand the sigma, you will get a naught plus a1x plus a2x square plus a3x cube and so on. Final term, what is that? a100 x power 100. Okay. But see here, a naught is missing. There is no a naught. So they started with a1. So a naught is missing. Missing means this vanishes. When the constant is going to zero, when we are applying differentiation, yes or no? Now this is differentiate with respect you to x. Okay, first go to the left hand side, derivative of x minus 2 whole power 100, 100 into x minus 2 whole power 99, internal derivative, that is 1. Now here 0 plus a1 plus a2 into 2x plus a3 into 3x square plus and so on. The last step, we get 100 into x power 99. But see the question, there is no x terms. That's why put x is equal to 1. Put x is equal to 1. So what happened, students? In left hand side, 100, 1 minus 2 whole power 99. But in right hand side, see that a1 plus 2a2 plus 3a3 plus and so on. 100, a100. Students, are you understood? So right hand side is the question. Now tell me left hand side. 1 minus 2 whole power 99 minus 1 whole power 99, that is minus 1. Overall minus 100 is the answer. So here shortcut method also is there. What is the shortcut method means? See here what we had done, overall one time derivative and substituted x is equal to 1. So f of x is equal to x minus 2 whole power 100. Then how to find a1 plus 2a2 plus 3a3 plus and so on, 100, a100. What is the shortcut formula here? That is f dash of 1. Remember it, this question, this type of model, they are given in September month, means f dash of 1. Okay, so here do the differentiation. What is f dash of x? 100 into x minus 2 whole power 99. Then f dash of 1 means what we get? 100 into 1 minus 2 whole power 99, that is minus 100. Actually, this is a shortcut method. Okay, so that means here, see the question. If a0 is missing, means the constant term is when it is going to vanishes when we are applying the differentiation. So shortcut formula is f dash of 1. Students, observe the 30th question. This is also same model, but small difference. What is the difference? We have to observe that. See the question here, a0 is missing. That means what they had done? One time differentiation. So now I am going to use here shortcut method, or you can go general method. Previous problem I am done now, same like. So here you have to think, what is f of x? 1 plus x square whole power n. Do the one time derivative, f dash of x. F dash of x, what we get? N into 1 plus x square whole power n minus 1. Internal derivative 0, x derivative 1, x square derivative is 2x. Okay, now we want to find a1 minus 2a2 plus 3a3. Here observe that alternative sign, same sign means there is previous problem f dash of 1, but here alternative sign, that means f dash of minus 1. This is a shortcut formula. Now already f dash of x we know that, f dash of x already we know that. Now find f dash of minus 1. Just in place of x, substitute minus 1. N into 1 minus 1. Minus 1 whole square. 1 whole power n minus 1. Into 1 plus 2x. 2 into minus 1. That is minus 2. Overall, observe that. What is the answer? Minus n. This is. Students, finally, what is the shortcut formula here? What is shortcut formula? F dash of minus 1. This is shortcut formula. Right? Correct option? 4. So by verification method, we add n is equal to 1, we got answer 1. N is equal to 12. Verify the options. If n is equal to 1, two options are coincide. If n is equal to only first option is correct. Okay, students. Now I'm going to another question. Same question is there in IP also. Now, go to verification method only. First, take n is equal to 2. Don't take n is equal to 1. Two options will be coincide. That is the reason. Not every time. So maximum 80% of the problem will be coincide. Now apply that. 2c0 plus 2c1 into 2c1 plus 2c2. Next term, see that here. 2c2 plus 2c3 is not exist. So that's why the completed term cannot be take. Only first two terms. Go to the denominator. 2c0, 2c1, 2c2. Only up to here enough. Now calculate this, students. Overall numerator. First term 1 plus 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3, 3s are 9. Divided by denominator 2. So 9 by 2 is the answer. Now verify the option. First option. If n is equal to 2 means 2 plus 1 whole square by 2. Yes. 9 by 2. It is correct. Second option. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 by 2 factorial. That is factorial notation. 2 factorial means 2 only. This is wrong answer. Now verify the first, third option. 2 plus 1 whole power 2 minus 1 divided by 2 factorial, that is 2. This is also 3 by 2 only. Wrong answer. Fourth option, students. 2 plus 1 whole square by 2 factorial 2. This is 9 by 2. Students, observe here. Third and first and fourth option coincide. Then what we have to do? So there is no option. Go to n is equal to 3 and verify. See, I am going to verify the question first. N is equal to 3. What happened, students? 3c0 plus 3c1 into 3c1 plus 3c2 into 3c2 plus 3c3 divided by denominator 3c0, 3c1, 3c2, 3c3. Now calculate the numerator terms. 3c1 is 3. 3 plus 1, 4. Into 3c1 is 3. 3c2 also 3. 3 plus 3, that is 6. 3c2 means 3. 3c3 means 1. That is 4. Divided by denominator. 1, 3, 3, 1. Now here, 3 2s are 6. Okay, 4 fours are 16, 16 twos are 32. 32 by 3, this is the answer. Now, I am going to verify that fourth option only. Or you can verify first option also. So, okay, I am going to verify the first option. See, 3 plus 1 whole cube divided by 3. How much, students? 4 cube, 64 by 3. So this is wrong answer now. Now which is correct answer? Fourth option only. So I'm going to verify the fourth option also. 3 plus 1 whole cube divided by denominator 3 factorial. 3 factorial means 6. This is 64 by 6. So 32 by 3. Yes. Fourth option is satisfied. General method. How to do this? Sigma r is equal to 2 to n. 5 r into cr minus 3 into cr. Okay. Now this is split that 5 sigma r is equal to 2 to n r cr. This is first minus 3 take outside sigma r is equal to 2 to n cn. Yesterday already I discussed this formula. Now see here, I am going to calculate first second one. See, sigma r is equal to 0 to n cr. What is the meaning of this? That is c0 plus c1 plus c2 plus and so on cn. Just expand the sigma. This answer how much, students? How much? Sum of the binomial coefficients, 2 power n or not? Yes. But here the limit starts with 2. Limit starts with 2. That means these two terms are missing here. Missing. Then those two terms send right hand side. Okay. So at that time, C2 plus C3 plus and so on, Cn. What we get the answer, tell me, 2 power n. C0 meaning is NC0. NC0 value is 1. C1 means NC1. NC1 value is n. So finally, this value is like this. 2 power n minus 1. But go to the first one. Sigma r is equal to 0 to n r cr. Expand this. 0 into c0 cancel. Next, 1 into c1 plus 2 into c2 plus 3 into c3 plus and so on n into cn. This is. So here started with c1 onwards. What about c0? It is going to 0. C0 is going to 0. Completely it is vanishes. That meaning is what? One time differentiation. So finally, this answer is n into 2 power n minus 1. N into 2 power n minus 1. But here the limit is starts with 2. So these term send it to right hand side, then you will get the answer. Okay.